Hello everyone, it's Roseanne. I'm back. This is going to be part two. And let me see. I think what I want to do, I'm going to save the back. And I'm just going to pull another one of these that I cut for this project. And if you're new, welcome. I hope you like what you see in my channel and decide that you'd like to stay and subscribe and leave me a comment and do the thumbs up thing and all that stuff. Welcome. Very happy that you're here. I'm very appreciative that you're here. I'm just going to, you know me, I love to have the frayed edges. So I'm just going to pull the fuzzies. Love the fuzzies. I don't know where my fuzzy container is right now. Just stick it in my scraps here. Hope everyone is doing well. Okay, I'm going to just crease here. This is a ongoing series for Angel Dream Crafts Kim. I have all of my little scraps. I've got all of my pretty fabrics and pieces from Kim. Bits and pieces of fabrics. Laces that I didn't use all up. Beautiful appliques. I think I want to do that. And I'm just going to be slow stitching. See, now that's a small piece. It'll go in the small piece scrap bag. I really want to if you weren't here on my first video, I mentioned that I wanted to, let me put some glue on this before I cut it. I mentioned that I wanted to do like a slow stitching book series for Kim's store using all of the scraps that I have. Once I build up a bunch of scraps, I like to use them all before I start cutting and making more scraps, because otherwise I just have a whole room, which I do. I have a whole room full of scraps. And this one is one of those that's sewn on, you know, the appliques I'm talking about now. And, I think this keeps sticking to my hand, to my fingernails. Yeah, let me do that. I think I'm gonna cut that off. My nail keeps catching. Yeah, I think I'm gonna cut that off right there. And I use these with the satin, no problem. I just, you know, fussy cut around it. And everything is fine. I swear my fingers are getting caught on everything today. Just cut that so that you don't see too much of that satin. And I hope I'm in screen. I rarely watch what I'm doing, guys. I'm really bad at this live stuff. Okay, and I just took off a pearl, I guess. Oh gosh, I'm taking off all the pearls. Good golly. I hope everyone is doing well. It's been really pretty here. I need to put glue underneath because I just want to make sure that that doesn't get... Okay. Yeah, the weather has been really, really pretty. Hope the weather is good where you're at. And normally, I live in the high desert, so where I live, it gets super duper hot. Like hundreds, over hundreds. Oh, I didn't really want to cover. Let me look at these other ones. Let's use this one. I want to leave some of the background fabric intact. Okay, now let's pull some more fuzzies. I'll fray that edge a little bit more. So yeah, it's been really, really pretty. Hubby came home for about 2 weeks and then he left again. And I have been busy ever since. We did lots of yard work when he was here. Oh my gosh. I don't know if I told you guys I was fighting with those of you that follow me, which there's probably not too many. I was fighting gnats. Oh my gosh, it was horrible. And like this or like this? I think I like it like that. Oh, doggone it. And I didn't thread my needles. Oh, well. So anyway, I was fighting gnats. I had the worst gnat problem where they kept coming in the house. They were just driving me crazy. What is going on here? I couldn't even eat one day because there were so many gnats in the house that they were plopping down, you know how they are. I was afraid to put my food down and have one plop down and then me end up eating it. It was so gross. So many of those little gnats that were just flying around the house. And they were getting in through the window because we had all the weeds because hubby had been gone and I can't do the yard work because of my hands. So I went to the Home Depot and bought some heavy duty indoor outdoor spray and got rid of them that way, taped up all the windows because they were coming in through the little cracks. Oh, it was awful. And I do not like bugs and things that are low to the ground, things that crawl around, I'm sure a lot of us don't, but for me, it's just, I get freaked out over an ant. I really don't like anything that crawls. It just drives me crazy. It was awful. Finally took care of it, and by the time hubby got here, all the gnats were gone because I had killed them all with all the poison. I breathed so much of that poison, but it was an indoor-outdoor, so I think I'm okay there, but oh my goodness, it was awful. So we took care of all the weeds, but we couldn't throw them away in the trash bin, so we got piles of the weeds around the house now, and every week during trash time, I need to fill up the trash cans and get rid of the weeds, but oh my gosh, that was an awful experience. This is a tatting string, I think. I don't know. I got it at one of my yard sales or something. Somewhere. I don't know. But I really like it because I use it a lot for, even though I have a ton of embroidery threads, I end up using this because it's neutral, it's really strong, and I use it a lot to bind my, to bind my journals. So, oh, come on, it doesn't want to go in there now. Really? Really? That's why I don't do this. I try to do it ahead of time, and this time I didn't. Because it takes up too much time. And I do have a needle threader somewhere. I just didn't bring it out. Okay, anyway. Oh my gosh, and now you're going to knot up. That's one thing about this, is it knots up like crazy, but I do use it to line or to sew my journal pages together. It's really good in that regard. Where's my end? And it's really strong for sewing. I tend to be really heavy-handed because of my, you know, my arthritis, I have to grasp things really hard or I'll drop them. So, I don't know how many turns I'm doing, guys. I'm just doing. I can't count and talk at the same time. Oh gosh, I don't want to sew that other page underneath. So I'm just putting some French knots in this piece here. Just to hold the flower down. Figure that's going to be the fastest way for me to hold it down. There we go. And I like the messy French knots. Unless I'm doing like a floral motif and I have to have them all the same, you know, size, or I need to be neat or whatever, then I really like the messy, you know me, fuzzy messy. So I'm gonna cut that and okay, I'm gonna need more thread in a bit. I was thinking on the other page that I wanted to put a really thin lace of some sort, but I'm going to wait until I cover. I'm going to be covering these, if you didn't watch the first video of the series, I'm going to be covering these once they're all sewn with tulle. And they're going to be like this, back to back. I will be sewing them, you know, like this, so that these are pockets. I'll sew the centers together so that they're pages. And then all of the sewing that I do will be, as you can see, on the inside. So I'll also have another piece here. And I figure after I do that, that's when I'll put the trim on the outside to hold it. And it'll kind of be like a shaker, because I'll be able to sew around and everything will be like encapsulated inside there. So that's my thinking. I don't know how that's gonna, if it's gonna work or whatever. I can put like beads or some of Kim's doodads from her store. I have a bunch coming. I have bows coming. I have lots of little tchotchkes that I can use. I can use more of these, like these little bits that will, you know, float around in there. The tiny, tiny ones I could cut, you know, from the appliques or whatever. But for now, this was given to me by Kim in a swap that we did, and I have this and another little chunk somewhere. I also ordered some of her buttons, and I don't have any right now. I do have this piece, though. This gorgeous bling. Which, pretty, pretty, pretty. This one is too big, so I'm going to cut that off. I had glued that on there. And used this on our hop sign. But we're not, you know, that was just a temporary thing. So I recycled all of those pieces. And let's see what I can do here. Okay, there we go. I recycled all those pieces. I'm just going to couch it on here. Because I'm not going to use that sign again for, you know, we're not going to have another hop. So I just pulled off all those pieces that I used to make that sign. And now I'm going to recycle them. I hope I'm in screen. Okay, I'm just couching this on, guys. And I might have to end up gluing this down to this once I'm done sewing the layers. I don't know if I can, if there's a hole there or not. Let me just, sorry, I should have done this. That's glue. Oh, look, there's a hole there. Can you see? Can you see that hole? So I can sew that bling there. And that way I don't have to add glue. I didn't want to glue, even though this piece already has glue. Let me see, where's the hole? Right there. Oh, yay! So these are sew-on. Sew-on blings. Go grab them. They're beautiful from Kim's store. Oh my, all this is from Kim's store, by the way. And let me see. I think there was more glue here. I wonder if that's another hole. When I glued it on, I did stick the glue in the hole so that it kind of holds. And I lost my tweezers, my favorite tweezers I used to use. I don't know what happened to them. Is that gonna come up? No, I don't think so. Well, let's do this. I'm gonna come back up through that one hole. If I can figure out where it is. Let me look where it is. No, it won't let me because it's too big, so I'm just gonna come up through here. And let's see if I can take that glue out of there. I don't know if you guys can see. If the glue came up, that means there's a hole there. And I should be able to sew. There you go. Woo-woo! What happened? Did I not just go through that hole? Okay, that was weird. Guys, did I not just go through that hole? Okay, super weird. Okay, anyway. I'm not gonna worry about it. Just wasting time here. I just stick this through. Let's see if there's a hole. Nope. Okay, we're just gonna couch it. There's a bunch of glue there. I'm gonna couch through the glue right there. You can see that chunk of glue right there. That'll hold it. Where's the end here? That'll hold it in place as I get glue all on my needle. I hate that. Okay, I think that'll hold. Can put just a little bit. No, because I sewed that part down, so I don't need to. Okay, I'm done with that. I hope you guys are enjoying this little mini series. And I hope you keep coming back so you can see the final project. Okay, and now I need more thread. Where's the end? Oh, my fingers are tingling so bad. 1, 2, 3. I'm gonna thread 2 needles. 1, 2, 3. While I'm at it, so that I don't have to waste too much time here. Hey, that was good. So it's been pretty quiet around here. Now that hubby is back in Trona. We had our 43rd anniversary come and go. But he did buy me a beautiful bracelet for our anniversary, which I will show once when I remember to put it on. I always want to put bracelets on when I do these videos so I could dress up my old hands, my old lady hands. I'm going to do one more, guys. Sorry. And I always forget. I'm always running 90 miles an hour. 1, 2, 3. And I forget. Last time I forgot to say the links were in the description below. And go visit all the other designers and how talented they all are. And I forgot to say all that, so I'm saying it now. Before I forget, please go visit the store. Visit, all the links are going to be in the description. Visit Kim's store on Etsy and visit the Facebook page. And I think she's on, well, I know she's on Instagram. I'm not on Instagram. I am, but I'm not. I'm not a big social media person. I find it wastes a lot of time when you get hooked into the rabbit hole of social media, and you go from one page to another to another to another. Pretty soon 5 hours passed and you don't know what happened. I'm gonna do this a whole white page, so I'm looking at these pieces here. So look at that. Perfect. Maybe. So I don't like to get that's kind of pretty too. I don't like to get I know I have little flowers all tangled up in the look at that. In the social media rabbit hole. Because I don't have the time to just sit around and be online. I'm always busy doing something. And I said I wanted to keep it all white, and I'm putting in pink. This is going to be for sale, by the way. So, ladies, if you are interested, I remember I made a flower out of this one. I loved it. Let's do that. I'm going to cut. Okay, see these little holes here? That is perfect for threading your needle through. I hope I'm online. I mean, on the screen. And I'm going to stick, because I know that's a big hole, stick my needle through, and that's going to kind of hold the threads. See, how pretty is that? Okay, I want to just tie a knot now. Super simple and quick. Okay, let me stick that right there so I don't lose it. Quick flower, and then since I have it all attached by the center there, I can add that's too big. Okay, I'm getting way. All right, let's do something else. And see, that's what happens when you have ADD. Is you get bored. Oh, I still have some of this. And I have this. Oh, look at that one, the leaf one. That might be cutie pie. Okay, and I'm gonna bring out the leaf. I'm gonna put that there so you can see it. I don't know if she still has this in the store, but this is my favorite. Actually, I love all of her laces. It's gorgeous. Absolutely gorgeous. These are all my longer laces. This is how I keep them, so I can just thumb through them. I have them in little bundles. Like, these are all my skinny ones. You know, smaller ones. Look, I have all these pretty. Look, there's more right there. Could have taken that one off. So, yeah. And then these are all my little laces. This is how I keep my laces. All my scraps, rather. And then I have, this one is all my dangles. So when I want to dangle, I can look. Oh, look, I could have used some of that too. Some of these. So that's kind of how I keep, like, see, this would be a dangle. Now this is a dangle, right? So that should go in here. I can do that later, but sort through here again. As I cut stuff, I make more dangles. Okay. Let's get back to working here. Oh, look at that. That's a cutie pie. Okay, I'm gonna see this. I'm gonna cut that little bit there because it's distracting to my eye. That's better. And now, if I put this heart there and put that in the middle, are you going to be able to tell it's a heart? No. So, I think I have hearts. I think I might still have some hearts. This one. But it's pink. I have a silver one. That's gold. It do have a button from the button, the vintage button. Yep, I think I like that. And that's a big hole. Yeah, that's a big hole. So, I think she has the colorful buttons still available in the store. Do I put it straight? Or should I angle it? I think I like it straight. Okay. Now, so this stays where I want it to stay. Now I got glue on the needle. I'm just gonna couch it down real quick. That way it doesn't move when I sew the needle and it turns crooked. Because I always do that. Okay, now it'll stay put. And I can add my button. I really want to use this. What if I put it at a, like at an angle? Okay. And it's going to be encased, so I just need to put one thread through and it's going to hold and tie it off and we're good. We're good to go. It's going to be encased in the tool, so I don't need to worry too much about, you know, having so many stitches around the button. See, and it still turned out. Oh my gosh. Okay, so pretty. That's a pretty page, right, guys? Oh, I love it. Beauty, beauty. Okay, well, that's my second page. Come back. We'll do the next pages. And this book is going to go really, really fast. So I'll see you all very soon. Thank you again, Kim, for all these gorgeous goodies. I love cutting them up to smithereens, as you can see. I'm always working with bits and pieces and scraps. That's my favorite thing to do. And so pretty. And this book is going to be really, really pretty. So keep coming back, guys. Please tell a friend. I'm trying to get to 10K subscribers. I'm going to have a big, big, big giveaway when I hit the 10K. And I'm going to have a few companies, as many as I can get. If you're a company and you want to support my giveaway, please send me an email. I'll have it in the description for my big 10K giveaway. And I will also be giving away something from me on my giveaway as well to celebrate hitting the 10K mark. That's a huge milestone for me. I've been online forever and it seems like I'm just never going to get there. I've been trying to get to 10K for 2 years now and I haven't moved. So all your help would be very helpful, ladies. I will see you all later. All the links will be below. Please go by and visit all the other designers. They are so super talented and they all have so many cool ideas. We're all different. So you'll be able to learn so many things from all of the ladies. And we all love the support, don't we? We all love to be loved and we all need to be loved. So spread the love around and go say hello to the other designers. And I will see you all in the next video. Bye, everyone. God bless and stay safe. And thank you again, Kim. I really, really, really appreciate and enjoy being on your design team. Bye, everyone.